probably heard about Alberta's oil sands.
But maybe you don't know too much about them.
We're here to change that. Today, we're going on a video field trip, taking you places no ordinary field trip could ever go.
We're going to find out what the oil sands are, how people use them, and why they're so important.
So here it is, the star of our show, oil sands.
If you could smell it, you'd know how it gets its name. These sands are definitely oily.
In fact, every grain of sand is covered by a thin layer of water and a coating of something called bitumen.
Bitumen is a type of oil, and it's what makes the oil sands valuable.
But how did the bitumen get there? 70 to 140 million years ago, much of Alberta was covered by warm tropical swampland.
Over time, the remains of all that lush vegetation became buried by layer upon layer of sediment. Gradually, heat and pressure within the Earth's crust transformed the plant material into oil and natural gas. That's the stuff that we extract today using conventional oil and gas wells.
Scientists believe that, about 50 million years ago, some of that oil gradually seeped eastward and upward, eventually soaking into sand and sandstone near the surface, like water into a giant sponge.
Then over millions of years, bacteria consumed much of the lighter oil, leaving behind the sticky bitumen.
For centuries, First Nations people knew about the oil sands and boiled it to make a tar for waterproofing their canoes.
When early European explorers learned about the oil sands, they believed that this mysterious resource would one day prove extremely valuable.
They were right. You can find oil sands in large areas of northern and eastern Alberta, and they hold incredible amounts of bitumen.
In fact, many experts believe that bitumen from these oil sands could meet Canada's energy needs for the next 500 years.
But extracting the bitumen, now that's a challenge.
Because on its own, oil sand can't really be used for anything.
One way to do it is to add heat. Now, let's try mixing our oil sand sample with a little bit of hot water.
After giving it time to settle, we observe three layers. There's sand at the bottom, water in the middle, with bitumen on top.
Now, here's a sample of bitumen on its own. You can't really do too much with it in this state, assuming you don't have a canoe that needs waterproofing.
Which brings us to our second challenge, turning the bitumen into something more useful.
This involves two steps, upgrading and refining.
At an upgrader, immense heat and pressure are used to break down the bitumen into a cleaner and runnier liquid called synthetic crude oil. Synthetic crude oil is similar to the crude oil pumped out of conventional oil wells.
And, like regular crude oil, synthetic crude has to go through a refinery. There, the oil is converted into gasoline, diesel, and other petroleum products, much more effective than trying to burn bitumen in a bus or a car.
So there we have the basics. Oil sands are oil in the form of bitumen plus sand and water.
They were formed millions of years ago and may represent a huge petroleum resource.
But it takes a lot of work to separate the bitumen from the sand and to turn it into something useful.
On our next field trip, we're going to get out of the lab and into the real world to see the oil sands industry at work.
We'll also look into some of the technological and environmental challenges.
But that's it for this oil sands field trip.
Ooh, except for one thing. Who's gonna clean the lab? Two out of three.